No professional angler is guaranteed entry into the Forrest Wood Cup. You have to earn it. And while it takes an entire season pushing yourself and making crucial decisions, there is one moment that will decide whether you achieve the ultimate goal. Throughout the year, you travel thousands of miles as part of a unique brotherhood of competitors, professional anglers who have trained for years to become skilled at catching bass.
There we go.
Your season is spent searching across constantly changing bodies of water for one key fish.
Game over right there, boys.
At any moment, you have to endure punishing boat rides and whatever Mother Nature brings against you.
Big line of thunderstorms coming through.
Big fish got me in the tree.
There will be missed opportunities that you have to put behind you. There will be mistakes you have to overcome. Because the Forrest Wood Cup is worth the sacrifice. It's the chance to rise to the top of the sport. To gain entry into the most exclusive club in professional bass fishing.
Your Forrest Wood Cup champion.
Along with the title comes enough money to truly change your life.
Woo! Look at that!
And when you can see clearly the ultimate goal ahead of you, it allows you to focus on the now. To put doubt behind you and clear your head of any mistakes.
Showtime now, brother.
There is no time left now for anything but the truth. And the truth is that all the hopes and dreams that ride out every morning of the Forrest Wood Cup cannot come true. 44 men will find that their best isn't enough. But for one man, Lake Murray will offer up a chance to make history, and it will come down to one final.
This is it, the big game, one final moment, the ultimate goal to claim the biggest prize in all of professional bass fishing, 2014 Forrest Wood Cup. I'm joined on the big stage by Chris Jones and the legend, Hank Parker. Guys, here we are, man. The greatest anglers in the world. Does it get any bigger than this?
It does. This is the mecca of all championships, Jason. It's the Forrest Wood Cup. $500,000 on the line to the winning pros. I tell you what, it's game on right now.
I can tell you that for sure.
Hank, you don't want to be on the sidelines for this, do you?
No, nobody wanted to set this one out. One of the favorites in this is Anthony Gagliardi, a local fisherman that is awesome. He came so close to missing this event, and it would have been devastating, not for just this tournament, but, I mean, his whole career was on the line for this tournament.
He's had the pressure since January to get here.
For five tournaments, he could not have one bad day. And now, all that pressure is mounted, but he's got the pressure on himself. He's expecting himself to win now.
Well, I don't think anyone ever said becoming a Forrest Wood Cup champion is easy. We know it's going to be 4 days of hard work. I think one of the biggest challenges, Chris Jones, is going to be who can actually bring a five bass limit up to these scales. I think if you can do that, it's almost going to be a huge success.
Absolutely, Jason. This is where it's going to take place right here. The angler that puts the most fish in here and the most weight, they're going to walk away $500,000 richer.
We knew Lake Murray was going to be a challenge. We're in the South. It's in the summertime. Why is it going to be so difficult this
year? Well, it's dog days of fishing, and it's tough everywhere. But Lake Murray is uniquely different from any lake that I've ever fished. These fish totally feed on blueback herring. And these herring are here today and there tomorrow. They're on the move. I guarantee you, in this event, as it unfolds, there's going to be guys catch big bags one day and zero the next.
Well, I don't think it's a surprise. 2008, when we were here, junk fishing is what won it. Junk fishing is probably going to happen again. A little variety for everyone. You like to fish deep, run up to the dam, drop shot 70 feet of water. You want to fish shallow, you can go up the Saluda River. I think we're going to see a lot of that guys moving all over the place the first couple of days.
I agree with you, Jason, but I tell you, there are two guys that know this pond very well, and that is Chevy Pro Anthony Gagliardi, and that is also Casey Ashley, who won at Lake Hartwell right here in this state earlier this year. Those two guys, they'll be two to watch.
The pressure was built up all year for me just to make it. You know, if I'd been having a really great season from the beginning, had fished the first tournament, you know, midway through the year, I might have already started looking ahead, you know, wondering, okay, how am I going to prepare for Murray? What am I going to do to catch him? But that didn't happen for me this year because of the way the year played out. So my whole focus was just on getting here.
Gagliardi was disqualified from the first tour event of the 2014 season for an unintentional violation of a new rule concerning practice partners. The only way into the Forrest Wood Cup is by gaining points at each of the six regular season tournaments. performance, and he had to sit the first one out, leaving him no room for a misstep the rest of the way.
When I was in that big hole, as long as I could leave that tournament, head to the next, and still have a shot, that was okay. I got a shot.
I have a lot of friends and family here, and winning in the home state, you know, a big tournament like this, it would mean so much. Everybody's fishing to win. Nobody's fishing to survive, so that's kind of going to change up, you know, how people do. Nobody's got an advantage really here. I don't care if you've lived here all your life. It's anybody's game. There he is.
That's a good one. Right now, Lake Murray is pretty doggone tough. I'm not sure everybody in this tournament really knows exactly how tough the fishing is going to be. And personally, I think it's some of the toughest summertime fishing that I've seen here in quite some time. I just got to stay focused and, you know, just grind it out the rest of the day.
Fishing in August is tough anywhere you go. The fish are ready for it to cool off just like you are. You know, you get like 2 hours of feeding in the morning, you get 2 hours of feeding in the afternoon, and that's pretty much it. The rest of the day, they just sit out there and rest. But like, man, you need to be doing on the couch in the air conditioning. He ain't big, but it's a start.
There's one. Yeah, baby. The guy that wins this one is gonna have put together three or four, you know, really just consistent, just quality days, and I think he'll take it home.
That's number five. It's 8:15 in the morning. Heck, can't go any better than that so far.
A wide range of emotions for the local Chevy Pro. And Hank, when you look at that, how do you think Anthony handled day one?
You know, that first 45 minutes, everything that could go wrong did go wrong. He was a bundle of nerve. And I think that he could have easily given up, but he stayed in there, hung in there, and put it all together, and he performed like a real veteran pro.
He did, Hank, and I tell you, he knows how tough the rest of this tournament's going to be.
Yes, sir.
You know, Chris, on the other hand, though, you've been saying all year, I really think this is the year a former Forrest Wood Cup champion is going to take control. Look at this. We have five former Cup champions still up for this thing.
Can history be made this week at the Forrest Wood Cup? At the end of day one, David Dudley, the Castro Pro, threw down the biggest bag.
18 pounds, 2 ounces is your new leader.
It's really hard to come away with a win in this sport. You can always be consistent and close, but to actually cross that barrier of being close and to come away with a win in this sport is few and very far between. So to get any title at all is a huge accomplishment. And to get a Forrest Wood Cup twice, that would be miraculous.
The topwater bite is fading extremely quick. You know, normally in the first 20 minutes is gonna be your best chance to catch a bass that's left over from feeding up at night up here shallow. Yeah, you get those voices going inside your head fighting with each other. Shut up, go Carolina. No, go shallow, shut up.
This tournament will be a lot of junk fishing. And by that, I mean, you might be fishing shallow 1 minute, and the next thing you know, you're fishing 30 foot deep.
My next hole is a Carolina rig hole. Caught one there yesterday and missed one, and only fished it once like a dummy.
2 hours without getting a bite, when you're in the Forrest Wood Cup, can play mind games on you.
Come on, you're supposed to be here. Only dot within miles. Fishing never ceases to amaze me. It's a grind. Here at Lake Murray, it's a grind. So now I'm gonna head back out deep. So the two voices that are fighting against each other, go shallow, go deep. He's winning this time. We're going deep. Okay.
I'm gonna tell you, he breaks me up. That rascal is crazy. He cuts up, but buddy, he gets the job done. If you look at his career, he can catch him. I don't care what the conditions is, Dudley's gonna catch him.
Yeah, he's good, Hank, but I tell you what, he's got a nephew named Philip Jerbeck. And guess what? He can catch him too.
17 pounds, 4 ounces has you in the lead, Philip Jerbeck.
Yeah, the Castro Pro takes out his uncle and goes to the top of the leaderboard, only his second year on tour. I mean, it's been a roller coaster every day. It proves that on day two, no one's been able to put together a successful pattern on Lake Murray.
This lake is so tough right now. The fish are moving so much with the blueback herring that you just have to move around. Like, if I get one bite somewhere, I can't get another bite there. I have to just abandon it and go try to find my next bite doing something completely different. That's what junk fishing is. You just have to be able to throw different baits in different places and just keep moving.
There's a bunch of those little minnows up there. If they're looking for bluegills, I don't know what they're actually looking for, but
It's not like they're sitting on cover and wanting to stay up there. They just go up there to feed.
You may run down the river, you may see a dock, you may pull over and flip the dock, you may run on up the river, see a lay down, throw a square bill down the side of the lay down. You may see some schooling fish. You stop and fish schooling fish. Junk fishing is fishing what's in front of you.
Going out and going fishing on your instinct, just like a practice day.
10 to 12, even 15 rods out, whatever looks right, and flying by the seat of my pants. That's junk fishing 101.
These guys, they can say they're junk fishing, but the guys that are standing left here now, they have an idea of where they're going to catch a fish.
Yesterday, I caught my two biggest ones in the same spot, so pull up on the right area, I think you'd catch them pretty good.
When the bite is so tough, five fish goes a long ways, and you've got to put your bait in front of five fish that are willing to bite every day. The faster I fish, the more water I cover, the better chance I have to do that.
And one thing I'm always doing is I'm always checking the weather conditions. If you see me looking up or looking around, I'm always looking for clues. There's little bite windows and times when a cloud will get over this certain pocket and times when the sun will come out for a little bit or a little bit of wind. And that really dictates how these fish bite.
Oh my goodness. And you kind of have to have that mindset that it's tough to catch a limit and just shoot for that limit. When you catch that limit, you're ahead of the ball game.
Number five.
Hey, this thing's unfolding. This is my kind of tournament. I like it. I mean, it's a run and gun. The fish are here today, gone tomorrow. It is a shootout, man.
The tougher, the better. Some serious drama. So here we are at the halfway point, and true drama and excitement is starting to emerge. Will Gagliardi make it to the top 10 on the final day? Will David Dudley lay the smack down on his nephew? Stay with us. The 2014 Forrest Wood Cup continues and is heating up from the famously hot Columbia, South Carolina.
The Walmart FLW Tour is brought to you by Straight Talk. Same phones, same networks, half the cost. Experience more at evanroot.com. Dingo, the big taste dogs love. Folgers, the best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup. Walmart, save money, live better. And by Kellogg's. From great starts come great things.
Coming from the biggest stage in bass fishing is the 2014 Forrest Wood Cup. And guys, with 20 anglers advancing onto day three, the lake, Chris, kind of provided a little change of conditions.
Absolutely, Jason. Cloud cover means that the fish will bite early, but that window of opportunity can be really, really quick. So you know those guys were anxious to get out there, Hank.
I tell you, they're fighting to make that cut. It's no holding back. It's so close, you can't save a spot. You better go for your best stuff now.
Well, we know that it takes 4 days to crown the next Forrest Wood Cup champion, but you know, a lot of people would say that it's day three when the true leader emerges.
I'm excited this morning. I'm in the lead, but I have a lot of really good anglers behind me. I'm just going to go out there and swing for the fences, as they say, try to catch as many and as big a fish as I can. The past 2 days, it's not been cloudy like it is today. I'm hoping it doesn't hurt it. It only makes sense it should help it, but it'll probably help everyone else's bite too.
Yeah, I want the sun out. I want it tough on everybody. I don't want them to have to earn it. I don't want them to just be able to go down the bank flailing.
This tournament's got the best fishermen in the country in it. And I love a tough tournament. I've been close a couple times. The last 2 years, I finished third 2 years in a row. And I want to win bad.
To win the championship is one of the goals that I want to accomplish in my career as a professional bass fisherman. I mean, $500,000. Who doesn't want that? I mean, it doesn't matter how much money you got, you want to win $500,000. Oh, we got number one. That's a lot of money. I don't want to put my name on that check.
This morning, I'm just trying to take advantage of the little bit of wind that we have. We have some cloud cover.
I was hoping there was one living there. I caught me one there yesterday.
On four-day events, you have to adjust. You have to make decisions. Bass are set up underneath these herring and probably 10 feet below the surface. So they might be up real shallow in the morning if they pull and push them up there, or they might be at the very tip of the point. We're all right. Don't panic. This next 30, 40 minutes is what I have is the bite window that I can run this shade.
Good one. Cool. Looking good, dude. Choked too. Boom! Yes! Big one. Yes! That's what we need. Couple more of them. Yeah.
Former Cup champion Bryn Ehler's been focused on deep brush piles down near the Lake Murray Dam, but he keeps an eye to the surface where bass will come up chasing the blueback herring.
Oh, I got two.
To win this tournament twice would be beyond words. You know, no one has done it twice, and to have this happen at this point in the game for me would be really big.
Oh, I got two. I got two.
I'll go ahead and take two in one cast. What do you think?
Ehler's now just one shy of his five bass limit, while things for Philip Jerebeck are decidedly slower as the second-year pro finds himself falling behind the rest of the field.
You don't get no checks for leading on day two.
18 pounds, 2 ounces.
David Dudley, Phillip's uncle, an all-time money winner in FLW competition, is also struggling. So far, his day three has seen a lot of non-keeper bass that don't reach the required 14-inch limit.
$500,000 on the line, and my day-to-day is like...
I changed up a little bit today from what I'd been doing, and I made a move to the other end of the lake. The guys that win these things almost always are able to piece things together and add to their practice period during the tournament.
There's a good one. Come on, baby. Yeah!
Now we're talking. Look at that. What I needed. That might give me to tomorrow.
New leader, 15 pounds and 9 ounces, 16 pounds even. He is your new leader, Brian Thrift, in first place. You need 13 pounds and 2 ounces. 13 pounds, 5 ounces. He is your new leader by 3 ounces.
Some of the most consistent fishermen on the whole circuit fell out, but hey, we have got Bryn Ehler, we've got Brian Thrift, and we got Anthony Gagliardi sitting at the top of the leaderboard. Those guys are gonna really fight it out.
And we still have three former Forrest Wood Cup champions. We've never had a repeat Forrest Wood Cup champion, so those three guys are still trying to make it happen. I mean, no question, a lot of drama on the final day. Are you still going with your guy, Gagliardi?
What a story is Anthony Gagliardi. Oh, I'm gonna hang with him, he's fishing tough.
Can you imagine the story? It's like writing a novel. You start the year off in the depths of despair. You finish out on cloud nine, the top of the mountain. It doesn't get any better than that. You know what? The drama continues. The fourth and final day of the 2014 Forrest Wood Cup is coming your way.
They look together and fun, okay? Don't worry.
The final round of the 2014 Forrest Wood Cup on Lake Murray is about to be underway. And for the top 10 men who've made it this far, the pressure is mounting because the richest payday in bass fishing is just 8 hours away.
Day four, Forrest Wood Cup on my home lake. Couldn't get any better than this. When you look at standings, it's super tight. You know, it's one of the tightest, you know, one of the tightest top fives that I can remember in the cup, which is awesome. You know, it's great. And it's great for me, you know, since I'm one of the guys down there in the top five in third place. You know, I want it as tight as can be since I'm not in the lead. So, you know, we all got a shot. You know, we definitely all got a shot. The competition is huge in this thing. This top 10 field is unbelievably talented. It's going to be anybody's game.
I would like to say I'm nervous and stuff, but I'm really not. I'm kind of calm because you can't, the lake's fishing so tough right now, you can't go out there with the expectations of you're going to catch them because you don't know if you're going to catch them. There's so many variables out here right now. I've got one little place I think I can catch a limit on if it's really tough. So that, I think that's what's keeping me calm.
I have the lead, and it's mine to lose right now. The fishing's so tough that anything could happen. So that's the first thing that goes through my mind is don't stumble. Go out, catch them. Don't stress out. If I can relax and fish hard all day, I should be able to catch them. But if you start panicking a little bit, then you start running, you start fishing too fast, and then you don't catch them.
Game plans are set, and among the top 10 are three former Cup champions, including leader Bryn Ehler, who won back in 2006. But the fact that the local pro Anthony Gagliardi is close behind doesn't give him a lot of breathing room. It's more of a long shot for the men in the bottom half of the field, unless someone makes a big gamble that pays off.
Game time now, baby.
Let's do it.
I hadn't caught a fish this week before 10:30. Bad as I'm trying, hard as I'm trying, I just cannot figure this thing out. Driving me absolutely stark raving nuts.
This is what you want when you're running a shallow topwater deal. You want it hot, slick, perfect. Water like glass.
My nerves are a little rattled at the moment. I got here to where I wanted to start, and there was a fisherman here already, which was fine.
Well, you just showed all these other people where the place is, too. See, that's the problem with it. Well, that, showing the whole world where the place is at.
What am I supposed to do, not try to make a living?
Get a damn job and work like everybody else.
Oh, okay.
That's what.
Okay, I'm not going to argue with you. I provide for my family doing what I love to do, and that's all there is to it. My nerves are as bad as they can be right now.
I'm shaking because it's like you have such a small window of opportunity here, and I hear him going, but I have to retie. For me, it's easier to be back just a hair and then jump out on the last day. It's tough when you're up there in the front because kind of all eyes are on you, you know? And it's tough to go out and have a level mind when the fishing's tough, when you're knowing that you're up there on top and you have nothing to do but stumble. Completely different morning than yesterday. Jeez. It's a nice one. Oh boy, that's a nice one. Stay on there, fish. Oh, stay on there, fish. Oh boy. Oh, I got him. That's a spotted bass. Boy, did I need that one. That's a good one right there. It's a spot on top of that. Got me a spot.
I've had two or three bites on top, so they'll still bite it. I'm gonna keep throwing top water till at least 10:30. I mean, that's gonna be my only chance to catch a big bag. I mean, I feel like all I need to catch is three. If I can catch three big ones on top, I can go fill my limit out. Be all right. Thank you.
Fish were feeding yesterday morning. Not feeding right now.
In here.
Number two, Forrest Wood Cup, baby. Come on.
The final day of the Forrest Wood Cup is all about dealing with pressure, and that's not easy when things don't go as planned.
You got any Xanax with you? My nerves are absolutely a jumbled mess right now.
They're just slapping at it or nipping at it. They're not getting the whole bait in their mouth.
It's just slow. It's a grind. I mean, you just got to keep at it, and keep at it, and keep at it. You never know when you're gonna get a bite.
It's very hard to fish slow when you know that the clock is ticking.
A five bass limit and a big bite is what every one of these guys is after. And Steve Kennedy thinks both can be found way up the Saluda River.
Had a lot of rain last week. Had a lot of flow down this river. The mayflies were coming off. I don't know if you can see these husks. That stuff right there is the remnants of the mayflies. Came out here looking for big fish. They're not easy to catch. If you get a bait down in the water like something slow they can get a good look at, they won't touch it.
Kennedy's approach is to flip a jig to wood and then throw a frog back as far as possible into the cover.
Just throw it over there, bump it. If I get it up in the cover real good, I'll bump it once or twice and then burn it out of there. And they'll usually smoke it when you start reeling. Guys, that's what we're looking for. We're trying to make it a ball game. Trying to make it a ball game, and that's the kind of fish to do it. Y'all see it, guys?
You know, right now I've decided to go and start running my deeper spots. And what I'm doing now is just throwing a drop shot around some brush piles. You know, the last couple days I haven't caught much anything on the jerk shad after, you know, about right now. And I know that I don't need to push it anymore. I mean, I could catch another one, but it's time for me to start running this stuff because this is, you know, how I've caught a lot of fish this week.
Yeah, today we've got zero clouds, just a little bit of a breeze. But I wouldn't have thought that would have hurt the bite. It's so weird how you can fish for 4 days in a row and 2 days they absolutely eat it every time they bite it, and then 2 days they just nip at it and don't even touch it when they try to hit it.
I don't know why it's so hard for me to trigger a bite. These fish are feeding. I mean, they're feeding hard. They're coming all the way up to the surface bus and the bait's large. And it's just hard for me to, it's hard for me to get one to commit to it. I could win it here.
I've ran a lot of new water today. Stuff that looked really good. It's just not paid off yet. We're gonna catch them.
Scott Canterbury is junk fishing, throwing at brush piles, heavy cover, and wooded laydowns. He's focused on the mid to upper portion of the lake, and he's running all new water.
You gotta find an area that's got some shade, and if it's got gravel or rock in it, it's on. I mean, you're gonna get a bite most of the time. What it is you'll throw up in that shade with a spinner bait or whatever you're throwing top water, and little bitty minnows just run everywhere out of the shade. They're not in the sun, they'll be in that shade, and you'll get a bite. You know, you don't get a bite everywhere, but if you put your head down, you can get enough bites. There we go. There we go. Starting to bite, baby. They starting to bite.
There he is.
Oh, that's more like it right there. It was a girl. I needed this one right here. Number two, and it's a good one.
It was a tough morning on Anthony Gagliardi as the schooling fish wouldn't bite, and he shared water with a cantankerous local. His second keeper is a good one, and he knows that the frustrations of this pattern can be worth it in the end.
I mean, what these fish are doing, it's random in a way, but there's reason. I think there's some reason behind it. You don't know exactly where these fish are gonna come up, but they use the same areas. As long as you're holding your boat in that general vicinity, then chances are you're gonna get enough times where they come up close enough that you get an opportunity to catch one, and that's what I do. And that's the way I like to fish. I love just sitting here anticipating when a fish is gonna come up and feed and making that cast, you know, on a split second's notice and getting that bite. I mean, to me, that's the most fun way for me to catch a bass.
That's a good one.
There we go. Thank you, Lord. Yeah, baby, that's what we need right here. Look at that one. That's it. Four more. That's what it's all about, guys. That's why I came down here to try to catch. These are big ones right here, dude. Oh, they're all 4-pounders. And I can't get one to bite. I won't get another opportunity like that one. That was $500,000 jumping around my boat just then. I should have caught one of them. I should have caught one of them.
Opportunities to win bass fishing's biggest prize can appear and disappear just as quickly. Staying positive, focused, and adaptive can be difficult under the late summer conditions at Lake Murray. But this is the Forrest Wood Cup, and these are the best anglers in the world, so they handle it.
And I just got my second win. I'm ready to go. I'm gonna get them.
Somebody's gonna figure something out today and probably catch a decent bag, shake things up a little bit, you know.
One of those 4-pounders, 5-pounders is gonna hit this thing at some point. I just got that feeling.
I can get one big fish in the boat, I think I can win.
While most pros are staying optimistic, Brian Thrift has started a downward spiral with two small fish so far, and the rest seemingly vanished into thin air.
You're supposed to have a bunch of fish. Everywhere I seen a big one yesterday, they ain't there.
With Thrift and Ayler struggling, the door is wide open for a comeback. And Steve Kennedy, who made the top 10 by just 1 ounce, is marching right through it.
Yes! Look out, guys, I'm coming for you. Woo!
With the weights extremely tight and the cup on the line, decision-making, poise, and execution have got to be flawless.
I have an advantage here. I mean, I fished on this lake all my life.
Anthony Gagliardi is hoping to make the most of this opportunity, his best shot at winning the cup, and complete his redemption of a season that started so wrong.
anytime the fishing's tough, I mean, I don't care how much you know about a place, it kind of becomes anybody's game. And because it is tough here, and we do have 100-degree summers almost all the time, I've not spent a whole lot of time out here fishing this time of year. I don't have any secrets to fish with out here. I'm not doing anything different than most of these guys. I'm just fishing. I'm fishing a fluke, fishing it with a little bit of weight on it, just so I can make longer casts, especially when these fish are breaking. I like to be able to
extend my fast a good one here, guys. Thank you, Lord. Number five.
He's not a giant, but he feels pretty good right now. Number five in the boat. Let's keep it going.
It ain't looking good, boys. I can't get a bite doing nothing. Only thing difference is a little bit of wind. I don't see how that could mess them up.
I'm not excited about the way the day's gone. I really needed a couple early, but not only that, a couple of these spots that we've hit right now, I needed to catch one on it, and I haven't. I have very few places left where I, you know, feel like I can catch them.
The final day hasn't gone as planned for Brent Ayler and Brian Thrift, who were in first and second place at the start of the day. Thrift continues the run-and-gun approach throughout his spots, while Ayler's forcing himself to slow down by drop-shotting brush piles that he's convinced hold fish.
I'm going to stick to my guns right now because I've fished a lot doing other things and haven't had many bites. This is the best way that I can go right to a spot and get a bite. The other bites I've been getting are random, just running. This is my best bet on going to one exact spot and thinking that there's a fish there.
That's a good one. Get out of that brush. Come on. Come here. Barely hooked. Oh, there we go. There's number two. Number two. Boy. Boy, I am needing some fish. And that one was good.
It's not supposed to be this hard. Should have just pulled in here and got five bites and been able to leave. I definitely need a limit. I've only got two right now. I thought I could catch a limit shallow flipping these bushes like this, but I don't know what's happened to these fish. Got to work for it. I keep thinking, let's get out of here. I keep getting bit. It's another solid fish.
Get in here! Woo! Number five, baby! Ah, baby. Number five! Woo!
Man, that was a grind to get five. It's a different deal than I've done, too. I mean, that's the first one I've caught that's like way, way, way back. I mean, like, that fish was in 6 inches of water. I'm running out of my primary deal. That gives me something else to go fish.
Get on up here. That's a 3-pounder. That one helps. 2.5. 2.5, he helps the cause.
The Walmart FLW Tour is brought to you by Ranger Boats, still building legends one at a time. Mercury Marine, 75 years of marine excellence. Plano, protect your passion. Find, navigate, dominate with Lowrance. Motor Guide, introducing the new XI5 and Pinpoint GPS. And by Chevy, brought to you by the all-new 2014 Chevy Silverado.
I'm shaking so bad I can't go. Dude.
You feel better when you catch your fifth one. But shoot, man, we're fishing for 500,000. and it just means I'm that much closer.
To win the Forrest Wood Cup would mean the world to me.
It's such a big tournament, such a big boost in your career.
It doesn't matter if you finish second. That's not good enough.
Money would last a long time, $500,000, but being a champion will last forever. So, I mean, it's all about getting that trophy.
The final hour of the Forrest Wood Cup is here, and the final test that will prove which angler is worthy of the richest payday in professional bass fishing. And a major championship has never been more up for grabs, with the weights bunched together so tightly that it's anyone's game, and it'll come down to one final moment.
Come on, boy, I'd like to catch me just one more decent one.
Some would say it's destiny for Anthony Gagliardi to win the Forrest Wood Cup on his home lake, and he's within reach of doing that. On his way upriver in search of a big bite, he decided to stop on some brush piles and make a few casts.
I'm fishing brush piles now. I'm fishing this fluke over top of some brush, just isolated. I mean, just either on a point or on a hump or on a flat. Just something that you can make kind of one cast at, and if they're there, or if one's there, if they're willing to bite, usually you can catch one pretty quick. There's a good one. Come on, baby, come on, baby. Yes! Look at there. It's a nice 3-pounder. Whew! Can't take much more of that. Man, he hit it right in the boat, scared me to death.
I have to catch a big one now. I have to catch two more. Two more fish, and I'll win.
Brent Ayler has been consistent all week. With less than an hour to go, he's focused on a deep brush pile, looking for his fifth fish that could be the key to a victory.
My confidence is, I mean, it swings up and down so many times a day, it's crazy. It's amazing the highs and lows in one single day on the water like this. I don't know if he's a keeper or not. Yeah, I think he is. He's not big. Oh, come on, fish. I gotta swing him. Oh, he's not, I don't think he's a keeper. Oh, he's gonna be close. He's a keeper. I got five. I'll tell you what, it's not enough. I got five, but it's not enough.
All right, fish, you better get it this time. I'm just fishing these deep brush. You know, I done hit five or six, caught one, hit five or six more brush piles, I ain't got bit. You fishing out here, it's like a needle in a haystack. It's a lot harder to hem one up in 25 foot of water than it is in 2 foot of water. That is the one we need. That's number five. We can get another bite like that. A game changer.
Thinking I'm gonna win this thing. I just need to call one with a big one, and it's over. I mean, I need that 5-pound bite.
Oh, God! God! Ah! $500,000 right there. Ooh.
Canterbury can only hope that this missed fish doesn't come back to haunt him, as the Straight Talk Pro does have a solid limit for the day.
That was ball game.
Had a miracle day. Truly a miracle. I have not put a fish in the boat as big as what all five of those are today.
Coming back all the way from 10th place would be a monumental achievement, and Steve Kennedy seems poised to do just that with his miracle run up the Saluda River.
Oh, there's another big one. Are you kidding me? Are you freaking kidding me? It's a giant. It's the biggest one yet, y'all. Huge. Huge. Look at that, guys. Wow! $1,000, almost guaranteed. Can you believe it? Can y'all believe this stuff? Can you believe it? That is a miracle. Truly, truly a miracle, guys.
It's too close to call, and the high-stakes final weigh-in is coming up next. Stay right where you are.
It's all she wrote, buddy.
The top 10 anglers head in to find out how their five fish will add to their overall weight and see who ends up on top of the mountain to claim $500,000. The bass fishing fans in Columbia, South Carolina were ready for drama, and it started right at the beginning.
He started in 10th place from Auburn, Alabama, Mr. Steve Kennedy.
He squeaked into the top 10 by 1 ounce yesterday. Do you have a five bass limit?
I do. Check these out.
Wow! 20 pounds and 2 ounces, 50 pounds and 7 ounces of Lake Murray bass. He's your new leader. Wow!
Kennedy brought in the biggest limit over the last 4 days of competition, and it's more than the next four anglers can handle. For now, Steve Kennedy appears to be in control of this event.
14 pounds, 15 ounces. It does move you to second place with 48 pounds of Lake Murray bass.
That will work.
He started the tour this year as a rookie. His goal was to get here, and here he is on the final day. He became a tour champion on Lake Hartwell earlier this year. Welcome the one and only Casey Ashley.
They won 9 pounds even, 11-14 on day two, and 15 pounds, 9 ounces yesterday. A five-bass limit for Casey Ashley. 14 pounds and 4 ounces to take the lead. A limit of bass worth 14 pounds, 4 ounces. He is your new leader on the tiebreaker.
Wow! South Carolina, what just happened? We're not done yet. The next pro coming to the stage, former rookie of the year, had the biggest stringer of the entire tournament on day three, Scott Canterbury.
After 3 days, he's amassed 37 pounds and 3 ounces of Lake Murray bass. A five bass limit. 13-4 will get you the lead. Five worth 13 pounds, 14 ounces is your new leader, Scott Canterbury.
Woo!
And I want it bad, man. There's some great fishermen still left, like I said tonight. I mean, if they beat me, they beat me. You know, I give it my all. I left it all out there.
Disqualified at the first event of the season, and now he's got a shot at taking home the biggest title in professional bass fishing, Anthony Gagliardi.
In 3 days, he's amassed 37 pounds and 4 ounces. Five bass limits! You need 14. One, watch it with me. 14 pounds, 2 ounces, you got it by 1 ounce. 51 pounds, 2 ounces, here's your new leader with two guys left. Wow.
Two anglers remain. You guys welcome Chevy Pro Brian Thrift.
In 3 days, he's amassed 38 pounds, 14 ounces. Lake Murray bass had him sitting in second place. Ounces off the lead.
That's all I've got, Chris. It was a tough day out there today.
Three bass today, worth 5 pounds, 8 ounces, moves you from second to sixth with 44 pounds and 6 ounces.
That's a good one right there.
Number two.
He's been there before in 2006 when he won the Forrest Wood Cup. He's looking to repeat again. Brent Ayler.
This time we're going to bring our leader back to the stage, Anthony Gagliardi. We've eliminated 43 anglers. Two left. Number four. Number five, a five-bass limit. You need 12 pounds and 1 ounce to win your second Forrest Wood Cup. A limit of bass for Brent Ayler worth 11 pounds, 10 ounces. Your champion is Anthony Gagliardi. Wow!
It gives me great privilege and great pleasure to present this check for $500,000 to you. Congratulations, Anthony. It didn't come easy. It's a great accomplishment. You won over a bunch of great anglers.
And it has been a roller coaster that started at the very bottom. It's on the roller coaster I know that finished at the very top. They always come back down, but this one stayed up. And I made one little key decision there in the middle of the day. I pulled into a place that I hadn't got bid on in quite a while, and I caught one of my biggest fish there. And it's just, I mean, every decision that I made this week, I think, was the right one. People ask me, well, what do you want to, what's your next accomplishment you want in your career? And it was definitely this. You know, this was the one thing that's eluded me. And to get it here makes it twice as special as it would be anywhere else.
Your 2014 Forrest Wood Cup champion, Anthony Gagliardi!
A heart-stopping weigh-in that won't be forgotten anytime soon. There may never be another Forrest Wood Cup that has the top five finishers separated by less than a pound. To get the most comprehensive coverage of the Walmart FLW Tour, including details about the lures and patterns used by the top 10, just go to FLWOutdoors.com.